poor folks of Haddonfield are never going to be rid of serial killer Michael Myers. On the one night when you think they'd have a shot, he's rushing around the little Midwest town making charcuterie boards out of residents. In Halloween Kills, the sequel to the 2018 reboot, Myers has somehow managed to escape a fire in Laurie Strode's home. Since no one in town has a real game plan, he's able to go anywhere, kill anything. Strode, played by Jamie Lee Curtis, is stuck in the hospital with her own injuries, and sure enough, she's convinced Myers is headed her way. Directed by David Gordon Green, the new film is bloodier and more cut and dried than the others. Instead of thinking this through logically, the townspeople gather like an angry mob and go nowhere near where the killer is. Anthony Michael Hall plays the seething leader of the pack, and he doesn't know what he's doing either. When he finally does get in the killer's sphere, he discovers nothing really works on the guy. Curtis, meanwhile, wrings her hands, worrying about her daughter and granddaughter, who could be on the hit list. Giving herself injections to be ready for whatever Myers has to offer, she's up and at him, but not in enough time to do any good. Halloween Kills, in fact, is like the second film in the Lord of the Rings trilogy. It goes nowhere, but it does point at another installment. Then perhaps the old babysitter and her nemesis will get a chance to go mask to mask and settle this once and for all. John Carpenter's original film wasn't as overtly violent as this one is. It played on emotions and fears. This one goes for the jugular, literally. When someone is killed with a fluorescent light bulb, you know Michael Myers isn't kidding around. He's controlling the town's population by whatever means necessary. With your movies in a minute, I'm Bruce Miller.